Hey everybody, Rich here. I'm calling this video Breaking Pentatonic because there are a lot of guitar players that complain about pentatonic scales. They say no one should ever do them. My opinion, of course you should do them because it's easy. It's probably the first chord style that you run style, whatever you want to call it, that you learn on guitar, so yeah, you should use it. So if you're going to do a D major pentatonic, which for most people starts on the B, or if you're going to do an A major pentatonic, I'm going to mess that up at the end, but you get the idea. I like borrowing from pentatonic a lot, not all the time, but you'll see it in certain aspects of my playing, and that's part of the reason I'm making this video, because some people like seeing the way I do my phrasing. So the chords I will be using for this one to break from the pentatonic, so to speak. Now, I don't know the names of these chords. If you know what they are, please feel free to post a comment and tell me, because I don't know. Well, first we have our standard B major bar chord. What I'm doing is I'm taking the pinky, which is ordinarily on the D string, and moving it two strings down to the B string, or the two strings, so it sounds like this. And if I was to play the whole, each of the note strings individually. Try that again. And in a strat-y sense, you can actually do hammer-offs or hammer-ons with that pinky, which is yet another reason. Get that pinky muscled up. It's good for playing, so you can do... Most people can't do a hammer-on with a pinky. They're like, oh, it's too weak. Well, get it stronger. Just do finger exercises, all that crazy stuff, whatever. Okay, anyway, the next chord is going to be an E7th with something added that I don't know what it is. But I'll play it for you. Before playing this chord, both the 1 and the 6 are going to be open for this one. So only the 2, 3, 4, and 5 are being played, held on frets, I should say. That's what it sounds like. And if I was to play each string individually, I'll do that once more. Sounds kind of weird, but when played together, it works. And you can also bend it a bit with all four fingers. If you don't have that's kind of the poor man's way of not using a tremolo bar, or as a whammy bar, as most people call, because I don't like whammy bars. That's why you never see me with one. I just don't care for them very much. But you can do the same effect just by doing a slight vibrato. You can even bend the neck a little bit, doing it that way. Yeah, and by the way, when I'm doing that, people have seen me do this, like, what are you doing? Okay, this is what I am doing here. I grab the top horn of the Stratocaster shape so I can take this hand and push forward, and I'm bending like that, and you'll see how it hits the back of my forearm here. So when I do this, or if I, you don't want to hit it like that, but you can, you got to be kind of careful when you do that, because you could snap the neck. And of course there's other ways to do crazy things on a strat, like bending the string after the nut. I think I just put it out of tune by doing it. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah, so we have the B thing, and we have this. And now we're going to break out of pentatonic. Now, if I was going to do pentatonic style with this, let me turn the volume down a little bit. Go down to a 4. And that sounds kind of sucky. It does. It sounds kind of boring. So instead of doing that, we'll just start at the B. And what I will do is a B and go to the 5 string and then one fret back, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is that the 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 6th. So I'd start 7th fret, 6, 5 string. I already lost my place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right. 6th string, 7th fret. 5 string, 6th fret, 5th string, 7th fret, fourth string, sixth fret. I'm a horrible teacher. I forgot where was it? 6-5-4. Fourth string, seventh fret. Yeah. This is why I don't like teaching, by the way. So anyway, it's... And yes, I am throwing a little bit of a swing. It's not just... And I am doing up and down picking to do this with. If you try to do it all with just down picking, it doesn't come out quite right. You have to get kind of a smooth motion going. Because you don't want to pick it too hard. And if I throw a swing style, you can hear the difference between that. It's subtle, but it's there. If I combine that, get that chord right. And it is so much better than... And I can go to the root of B, which is a B octave. So, and then I can go into a pseudo pentatonic after that. So if I... Now if you were to ask me what kind of scale is this, I don't know. It's not minor, it's not major. I don't know if it's augmented, I don't know if it's diminished. Again, if you want to tell me what it is, post a comment. But anyway, the point is that I'm doing a middle finger, 7th fret, 6th string, and then the 1-2-1-2 on the 5 and 4 strings. And then a slide up. And then a pentatonic back down, if I chose to do so. And when I go to the E, this one, all I have to do is do the same thing I did before, starting on the 5 string. See how easy that is? So I go. To the E. Messed up a little bit. Now to add some flavor, if you will, when changing chords, you can... Chords? I can't talk today. When changing chords, you can do what I call a one fret jump. It's like a staccato type of thing. I probably am completely applying this word wrong, but anyway, the point is if I go... So, what happens is that there's that E7th there. E7th added something or other. But when I change to it, I can actually just take that, what I'm holding here, go back, and then go back up. Actually, no, that's not true. You start back one fret, and then up, so. It's very subtle. Right. You can do that also when going back. This is a little tougher to do because you're using your whole hand here with the bar, so. If you can't get that, that's okay. It takes time to learn it. Okay, so, and then the end of the whole thing is that I will use a pentatonic with added notes backwards. And this note is technically not a pentatonic, but it has the same shape, if you will. So if I'm doing a D major pentatonic right there, so you know it's... I'm only using the 1, 2, and 3 here. And what I'll do is I will add in a few notes. And I'll do it again in case you want to follow along with me. And if you're asking me where the hell does that fit in, I'll show you in a moment. Now, in a standard blues reference style riff here with a swing jazz sort of whatever, I'm doing this. So where's the final chord? It's actually... It's the E, and then moved up to a F sharp. So if I was going to do this straight, like no swing, something like that. Yeah, almost lost my chord. So the whole thing put together try this out. Expecting you to get that first try. It's just something different. It's something out of pentatonic, something jazzy, bluesy, something or other. I don't know. So again, the chords are that one, which you can play all six strings. Actually, you can do all six strings with this one. Do all strings, six strings with this one. This one you cannot do all six strings because it sounds awful. So you can't do the six. You start at the five. And you can open the play the one open if you want to. So that's the only one where you can't do all six strings. So again, it's and then and this one start playing on the five instead of the six and mute that six or just avoid it. And then you can bend your neck if you want. But anyway, and of course there's the beat, which is the swingy type of thing. Say that again. You can go all over the place with stuff like that. That's why I like playing in B so much, because B is just cool, because it just goes to E seventh like peas and carrots. So sounds cool. But anyway, if you have any questions about what I just did, I know I am a horrible guitar teacher. I'm not saying I'm any good at teaching anybody anything when it comes to guitar, but at least I'm not doing that. Oh, do your pentatonics. Oh, do your this, do your that, do what you want. Play what you want. As long as you're in time and in key, that is all that matters, right? Right. So, ask. I'll try to answer as best I can. And also remember, the conversation's good on my Facebook page, too. Facebook.com/richmenga. So be sure to check that out too. You can post away, and I like the comment system on Facebook better. It's just the whole thing is just better. YouTube's comment system, yeah, that's how I describe YouTube's comment system. Two for the price. Two raspberries on YouTube's comment system. Freaking horrible. Subscribe.